In her final interface before leaving India, the Prime Minister told Mumbai business people that language, culture, and incentives are the key factors why South-South cooperation should be more than just handshakes and talk shops, and that the time is nigh for India and Trinidad and Tobago to take advantage of available opportunities.
Let this not just be another talk shop. Let us make sure that at the end of this, we do have the follow-up, we do have the partnerships that will benefit your nation, yourselves, and of course, my nation and my citizens.
The MOUs with Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, the various agreements signed by the respective ministerial delegations, and the great rapprochement demonstrated on both sides have paved the way for positive economic gains. In an earlier intervention, Trade Minister Stephen K. Dees sought to contextualize the success of the mission.
Rest assured that we and India are on a steady path of mutual cooperation, which I believe will be a catalyst for enhancing both our economic futures. Our discussions today can only complement our alliance.
We have convened in excess of 40 one-on-one business meetings. We have held numerous informal discussions with business networking meetings, such as this one here today. We expect to see results as InvestTT has signed a number of MOUs, five in fact, to facilitate further discussion and to provide assistance on the ground, as many of six have already expressed their desire to visit Trinidad and Tobago within the next 3 months to continue discussions and to conduct the necessary feasibility studies to develop project proposals to take the business relationships one step further.
Sports Ambassador Brian Lara felt reassured about business prospects here based on his personal experiences in cricket.
Indian businessmen are not going to have luncheons and dinners with our energy ministers or any of our ministers if cricket is not the dessert. They love cricket here, and I believe that our presence come a very long way.
And this is how the Prime Minister, in continuing to brand Trinidad and Tobago, brought to an end her grueling 13-day state visit to India.
Rest assured that we and India are on a steady path of mutual cooperation, which I believe will be a catalyst for enhancing both our economic futures. Our discussions today can only complement our alliance.
An historic telepresence session with Indian and local media, and a light evening with music and lots of flowers from her Bihari kinship, culminated the day's activities and what seemed like 300 hours crisscrossing the Asian subcontinent. Gideon Hanuman Singh reporting from Mumbai, India.